Girl, I am too. I weigh 200, close to 240 pounds, and I don't know what that means in stone. I'm sorry.
That is fucking funny. I walked by the mirror and looked at myself like, you disgusting bitch.
I'm a big girl, but I mean, I'm proportionate too. I'm a big girl, and like, it's not like freaking eating a mass amount of eggs. That's just makes my day. That's just hot.
I will eat mass amounts of anything. My mouth at the moment is just like a Hoover, and I open my fridge and just suck all the food out of it.
She had the Garfield moment. She'd be like standing in front of the fridge, and her mouth would make the back end way. She's like Garfield.
Yep. This is why I fucks with you too. Y'all keep it 100. That shit was funny.
That is too dead weak. Barbie, I'm gonna send you a friend request because I gotta get ready. I gotta actually go try to go to bed because I gotta
try to get up and
sleep so you can guys work.
Boom. Yeah, I actually like my job. It's stressful as it can be sometimes.
As motorboater, professional motorboater.
Okay.
Oh my god, you're right. Professional.
what do you do at work?
You just hand out your business cards.
I know, right?
She just puts them in between the boobs. What do you do? There you go.
There was this one girl where I could barely get the measuring tape around her, and I was stuck in her boobs for like a hot minute. I was like, I'm so sorry.
She was getting low-key wet. She's like, oh my god, this is my day. Yeah.
Not really. She was not very visually appealing to me, and I don't mind as much. I have standards, so, okay?
Are you straight? Are you bi? Are you lesbian?
Theoretically, I'm bi. I say theoretically because I'm not really.
Theoretically?
Because I'm married. It's kind of different. You have to kind of stop.
Okay, so what is theoretically like you think about girls, but you don't get with girls?
Yeah, basically.
I like that. I was going to say, like, I would feel so awkward, like, being face planted against boobs. I think it's a fucking amazing job if you're bi.
Oh yeah, it's pretty amazing. Cause sometimes the girl's like really pretty, and I'm like, and I'll be like, hey, you need an updated bra fitting, and she's like,
hey,
yeah, you know what? I really should get an updated bra fitting. So I'll do that. It's like,
That's how she gets them. People don't even think about it until she brings it up. You need a new bra?
They're all just going in there to get a dress or something. And she's like, no, you need a new bra as well. You can't have a new dress without a new bra. Come on.
You need a new bra? I came here for jeans.
Yeah, exactly. I'm like, but a t-shirt bra, though. They're like, it does have your breast up pretty high. And girls are like, admiring my breasts and stuff. They're like, your boobs are like so perched up there. I was like, it's the bra, honey. I sag too.
Me too.
I think that happens to anyone that has big boobs. My sister got blessed with boobs, and she has massive fucking hips, and hers are sagging as well because obviously they're too big.
Gravity doesn't like us.
Gravity, yeah, physics.
I got that problem too. What do you think? Come on. I got a third leg.
Aww.
I got a third fucking leg.
You are a field trip. I'm done with you.
I got back problems right now. Like, I might get a dick reduction or something.
I'm like, as a black man, that's like against the law to do that. So I don't know.
That's why I haven't done it yet, because, come on, it's a gift and a curse.
Yeah. Cause like,
yeah, well, you can only go so far in, so I don't know how much of a gift it is.
Oh my god, dead week.
Oh, believe me, I get all of it in one way or another. I made so many jokes.
Tell me why, like, even playing them, sometimes the bigger girls that come in my store be throwing shade at me. They don't realize I'm just as big as they are. It's just, I'm just proportioned differently. Because I'm an American size 20, 22, and like, a lot of these other girls. Roughly that same size, but I have a small waist somehow, and like just really big hips, or whatever. And
but that's kind of like the best thing, though.
Hell yeah,
like, having a small waist. Because some guys,
I had a tummy though. It's just, but like my pants kind of hide my tummy a little bit, but I have a tummy. It's just, I'm just more about how it shapes. I got a little belly.
I think it all comes down to what you wear as well. Like, some clothes can really make you look super sexy if you've got some weight, and then some of it just makes you look like a troll if you wear just like leggings that are half sliding down your ass or something.
Thank you. And a lot of these girls in Hawaii be wearing that shit. Oh my, look.
I know, I'm in England.
I'm about to go to Hawaii.
Like, my friend Caitlin, she's a big girl, and I wanted to take her out shopping to get like clothes that would actually make it like work with her body size, but she didn't want it. She basically just looks like a, I don't know, a troll most of the time.
I don't know, troll.
You want to hang out?
It's not because she's ugly. It's not even because she's fat. It's just because she don't even put effort into how she like presents herself.
I feel like every time you guys go out, does somebody like pull something from like the first Harry Potter movie, and freaking Professor Quirrell like troll in the dungeon. Catch you on the nose. Thanks.
See, I didn't even know all that. I've never watched Harry Potter, never read Harry Potter.
I am the Queen of Shade, okay?
I've watched Harry Potter. I cried when Dobby died.
I cried too. I cried like a little.
It was a heartbreaking moment for me.
Yeah, but I
looked like a weirdo. I was with my friend Caitlin that I was just telling you about. We were both sitting there. And I don't know what happened. I think I was just having a really emotional day. And then Dobby died. And I just burst out into tears in the middle of the cinema. And people just started looking at me and shit. And I was just like, look at the film. Fucking hell.
I'm like, Dobby's a free elf. Like, Dobby, like, was a G.
I was like, Caitlin, Dobby died.
I'd be looking back like, really? It's a movie.
Yeah, I know. People were. I look like a crazy bitch.
But you know what, though? If you read the book and also saw the movie, too, it's, like, even more emotional. Because I read all the books before I saw the movie. So when I saw the sixth movie, I'd had surgery, like, I think a week or two before. And I was in some serious pain medication. And my friend took me to kind of get me out of the house and cheer me up. But I've been really sad. And then, of course, you know,
because of Dobby.
The Dumbledore gets God. When Dumbledore gets got, I'm just sitting there like crying. I already knew what was gonna happen because I read the book, but I'm just ugly crying in the movie theater. I'm just like, he's like, you knew this was gonna happen. I was like, I don't care. Why is Dumbledore have to? Why? Why did he have to die?
My crying face is so ugly that sometimes I actually look at it to make myself cry more.
That's wow.
Really intense.
And I literally like, do you ever have a moment where you just want to like cry and let out your sad emotions?
No.
And you just have to kind of watch something to spark it. Yeah, sometimes you just need a good cry.
Yeah. Well, all I do is look at my crying face and it makes me more sad. So I just.
You need a good cry. Anyone here just need a good cry every once in a while.
I love it though, because I think after you've had a proper good cry, you feel so kind of relieved.
Yes, actually crying is known to release your endorphins and actually help with that. And also,
recently science thinks that tears are a way of taking out used hormones out of your body. So like, if your brain uses certain hormones, when it's done, you'll cry them out. It's kind of like your brain's way of going for a pee.
I like that.
You need to be like a stand-up comedian. Oh my
I like
God.
That. Yo,
I'm gonna
tweet that. Okay. I'm tweeting that shit. I'm giving you the credit for that.
Awesome peeps. I'm carrying my black and Italian ass to bed.
Okay, enjoy your sleep. Try again.
All right.
As much as possible. So, you
I'm
have enough
fresh.
Energy for
my...
about in tomorrow?
For real.
I want to hear some motorboat stories tomorrow.
Oh my God.
Nice, he'll probably just pass out with the tape wrapped around them, and they'll be thinking she's taking the piss. She just wants to be laid off my tits.
Wait. This girl. Oh
ma'am, can you please stop drooling on my tits?
I'm like, I'll just I'm just going to leave. You can just
I'll
send me my
I'll give you 10% off. It's okay.
Yeah, exactly. I'm going to give you 10% off.
This bra's free because, you hear. Sorry, I drew it on your tits, by the way.
It's okay. I don't know. The girls be liking me. They'd be like, I like you. You're funny. I'm going to come back and see you. I was like,
I bet you'd be getting mad. I bet you'd be getting mad numbers, huh?
Nope.
Don't lie. You'd be spitting mad.
Nah, to be honest, if I went to get myself measured and things and the girl was just kind of, I don't know, cash. Do you know what I mean when I say cash?
No.
I can't take
casual, clues. Like, relaxed.
Oh, okay.
Like,
yeah,
easygoing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, if I have got measured by someone like that, I would be so much more comfortable than someone just there staring at me and doing their shit.
Oh, yeah. I try to be as cash as I like that cash. Sounds cool.
I like that too.
I try to be as cash as possible when I'm there because I don't like to make people feel uncomfortable. I know
And it's that kind of thing. I think especially when you're a bigger woman, you're more self-confident, self-conscious about your body, so you don't want to go somewhere and then someone turns out to be a bitch. I think I would probably punch someone right in the face if they laughed at me if I got naked. I don't know what I would do.
You know, and it's like...
I would probably just, like, hit the floor like I was doing press-ups and lay there until someone... put stuff over me.
Here's a blanket. Here's the blanket. Yeah, I don't know. She's kind of collapsed, but there's nothing here.
Because when people are buying us stuff in the dressing rooms, like, they're like, Cupcake, what do you think of this dress on me? And I'm like, I think I need to go, you know, freaking fix the clearance rack. I'll just freaking obliterate it. But sure, I'll get some fashion of us. We didn't ask for. And they were like, but a lot of times, though, I'd be like, yo, I'm like, you look hot, though. I'd be like, yes, bitch, slay. I'd be saying all that, you know.
Yes, bitch, slay.
I'd be saying all that unorthodox shit. I don't know how I still have a job, but they'd be like, I love that girl back there. She's so funny. I get a bunch of compliments and stuff, so I guess it works.
But I think if you're genuine, anyone loves people that are real. And if you're just being real... and you're telling someone how it is, then I think most people like that. You're probably going to get a stuck-up bitch come in and be pissed off with it at some point, though. But...
I did have someone, one of my first customers the other day, it was kind of like early in the shift, it was like this lady and her mom, she needed a new bra. Her mom was just very, very like, you know, some people can just be like overprotective and stuff. But the girl was like 30. The girl was like older than me. She was like 30.
Oh my
or
God.
She was older than me by like a few months or whatever. And it was like...
She needs to stop breastfeeding then, innit? What's that?
And then it was like... And the girl was acting like... The girl was not having any of my humor that morning. And,
Don't you hate
that?
When you're trying to be funny and everyone just stares at you.
Yeah.
Just stares you down. I'm like, bitch, just give me the sympathy laugh. I don't care.
For real, give me something. Give me something. Like, I'm giving you A1 material right now. Like, you're going to laugh one way or another.
I always just picture tumbleweeds rolling in front of the bat.
Oh my God.
Yes.
Every time I say something.
Because you know what I want to do is I want to be like, look, bitch, first of all, if it's 10:38 in the motherfucking morning,
you should be happy.
I got my adult hour, though, and it's taking a sweet time to kick in. I've only had a few sips of my coffee. I can tell you already, I didn't eat enough for breakfast. My face hurts. My whole body hurts. I'm getting over a really, really bad crisis. I'm like, right to the ER on second day. You will fucking laugh at me. You fucking peel that shit.
You're gonna fucking
after
laugh.
Birth, I'm going to go to the
I am funny, god damn it.
I'm like, you will fucking laugh at this fucking black Italian girl standing in front of
you. Oh, you will not leave this shop.
I am resplendent in samples of Dior and/or Dolce & Gabbana. You will look at me, you will marvel in the fact that I managed to put myself together, even though I am struggling with both ADHD and anxiety disorder. And yes, I do have some cat fur on my shirt. However, notwithstanding, I fucking slay. I am wearing a Harry Potter lanyard. My nails are sparkly. and honey blonde, biley-ish. And yes, it isn't a bun, and it's all my real natural hair.